Hello everybody, welcome to the Python tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to set up a rock, paper, scissors game. The idea is like this. You give a move first, and then the computer will give a move in response to your move. And you can lose, win, or draw with the computer. And then after you have played the game for a number of times, you can decide when to quit. And after you have quit, the computer will count the number of wins, draws, and losses. Let us see how we implement the game. Because the computer needs to generate a random move, we have to rely on the random module. So we have to import it. And before we do the game, we have to set up some variables first. We have to set the number of wins, draws, and losses to 0 first. We have to see whether the game ends or not. So we want to continue the game at least for the first time, so this variable is set to false for now. And then we set up the prompt that will be used very frequently. Okay, this is the prompt to tell the user to input the appropriate move. And then we can do the looping. Because we don't know the number of times the user is going to play the game, we cannot use a for loop. In this situation, we can use a while loop instead. We can use while true here. While true means that we will always do the looping, except that it has some breaking action inside the while loop. So we will investigate the breaking condition later. Okay, the user choice is equal to the user input. So it is either R, P, S, or Q. Of course, the user can input anything else. How can we ensure that only these four letters are allowed? We can do a small while loop to force the user to input one of the four letters only. If the user choice is not in one of the four letters inside this list, I will show the prompt again and the user has to input the letter again until he or she can input one of the four letters correctly. If the user choice is Q, I will break. Here, when we see the word break, it means that when the user choice is equal to Q, I will leave the whole while loop. It means that I'm going to end the game by not repeating all the things again and again. We will see the effect when we run the program. If it is not equal to Q, we really want the computer to give a move in response to your move. The computer will give you one of the three moves. if the computer trust equals rock, I will print the move to be like this. Else, if the computer move is another one, if it is P, I will print paper later. If the computer move is not rock or paper, it means that the move will be scissors. And I will print the computer move. Okay, and then since the computer and the user have given the moves, we can determine the winner for this game. We handle the draw condition first. If both choices are equal, it means that we will have a draw. The number of draws will be incremented by 1. Additionally, we have draws to be 0. So if we have the draw for the first time, the draws variable will become 1. If we don't have draw condition, we have to consider the winning condition. It is one of the conditions that the user wins. The user gives a paper and the computer gives a rock. How about another condition? Like this. User gives scissors and the computer gives paper. User gives rock and computer gives scissors. For all these three conditions, the user wins. So we print out this result. You win. You means the user. The number of wins will be incremented by 1. If the user is not winning, or if the user is not drawing, it means that the user loses. The number of losses will be incremented by 1. Okay, when the loop completes, I can print out the results. We will go to this stage. That means we will leave the while loop with the user choice becomes Q. So what will we do when the user choice becomes Q? We can do something like this. I just want to print out the number of wins, draws, and losses. Like this. Okay. So let us see the result when we run the code. I choose rock. I get a draw. How about when I put other letters? K, which is none of the four possible letters. Oh, the computer needs me to input the letters correctly. So I have to input one of the letters, for example, paper. I give a draw as well. How about rock this time? I lose because the computer gives a paper. And how about scissors this time? I still lose. How about a paper this time? I win. And how about rock this time? I lose. Okay, if I want to quit, I simply press Q. And after I've pressed Q, I will have the result. I have 1 win, 2 draws, and 3 losses. This line of printing is possible because when we have a user choice equal to Q, we will break the while loop. That means we don't do the looping again. And we will leave the for loop and run the rest of the code shown here. My implementation is intuitive and straightforward. However, it may not be the best solution or the most efficient version. If you can think about any improvement of my code, please post your code below the video on the comment section on this page. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.